You can hear me? Give me a thumbs up. Thanks. So, welcome to my talk about teaching a vacuum robot to be a web radio in Go. And I let it up to you to decide if I got up with this awkward title after I was a little bit drunk, or maybe after an 8-hour session of coding and I read the call for proposals on Twitter late at night. So, a little bit about me. My name is Tobias Kohlbauer. I'm a software developer at My Open Factory Software GmbH. And in my nighttime, I often have a passion for embedded devices. That's why this talk about hacking an embedded device. My Twitter handle is @toktech, and GitHub is Tobias Kohlbauer, where you can find later on the slides and the source codes. So what's our object of interest today? It's a Xiaomi Mi Robot Vacuum Cleaner. I don't know how to pronounce Xiaomi rightly. Xiaomi, maybe this way. I don't know. I don't care. And this is the device. It works like a charm. It's silent. You know, I'm just kidding. We don't deal with this kind of stuff here. We deal with hackable stuff. So it's Ubuntu powered. Under the hood, it has an ARM57 core. And the most, I don't know where the point is, but the most important part is you can root it without ever touching your device. There are some guys from the university, I don't know anymore, but on the short link below, you can find their talk. They hacked it with a gum paper, and afterwards you can emulate the update server from the officer side and can directly emulate it and download every software you want onto this device. And after you have root access, we know we can do everything. And that's what I did. What was the motivation? As I turned it on, because of course I didn't buy it for hacking it, I bought it for cleaning my household. And that's when you turn it on, it talks to you. And I said, what? Just did my vacuum robot just talk to me? And after I realized, yes, he did, quite loud, I realized I want to hijack this. And after this, the thought process was, the base station is in my bedroom, and I ever wanted to have an alarm clock which can wake me up with music. And why buy something if you can build it by your own? That's why I hacked this thing, and approximately 10 hours later, a reference to this late night coding session, I found out, yeah, we can cross-compile some Go, we can use a library which someone produced an MP3 decoder poorly written in Go, and feed this into the audio device which is onto the robot and running it on the vacuum. And this is the awesome of Go. We can just use the interface IO reader and IO writer and directly pull down an HTTP request which has the MP3 file and directly feed it into the MP3 decoder in this lines. And afterward, we can feed it into the auto new player. This is from the same guy, a little library which can deal with native audio hardware for Windows, Linux, and co. And you know, it's real cool stuff in Go if it is with error handling on one slide. And in the bottom part, we directly copy from the reader into the writer. And if you open this up, you got music. And to finish things up, it's of course, we have to build a web server because no one wants to hack every time on his robot to change some audio files or something. So, and if you're like me, a backend developer, you more like a REST API than some guys call it magic. I call it magic, other people call it UI. I'm not good with it. That's why REST API for me, UI for other people. And now I want to show a little bit how I hack together everything. So I want to start. What I have to talk about, it's big enough, or should I make it a little bit bigger? Isn't it here? There. So, no. Maybe one more. No. Do you prefer them? I can switch, but I don't like them. It distracts my eye. So, yeah, the most fun part is, maybe someone read the little overview I put online before. You can do this all in about 2 megabytes, and there are some tricks how you can do it. The important part is, if you cross-compile something in Go, it's very easy. How? Wave your hands if you have cross-compiled something in Go for another. And the other ones who don't know, it's so easy. If you do it with C, you have to put it in a build chain, a tool chain, cross-compile everything. It's so annoying. And in Go, you use this two keywords which are called Goes and GoArch. Don't call me out for this pronunciation. It's Rob Pike who has very sometimes special ideas on how to call things. So it's Goes and GoArch. And if you put in Linux and ARM, you directly can say cross-compile. You don't have to put in a toolchain. You can download the binary from the website. Everything works. And combining this with a little bit of Windows subsystem for Linux magic, you can pass forward and backward variables and compile it cross with some CGO flags. And after you cross-compiled it with a native toolchain, which is a little bit of a hassle because you have to use it for the audio device driver, you can get out a bundle. And if everyone is curious what this mage file is, I want to give a little shout out to this awesome project. If everyone likes Go and hates Bash and make files, use mage, because you can directly write your automation scripts and everything what you want in Go, the language we like all. So you can, for example, if I'm in the right directory, we can directly call this target like in make, and we can cross-compile it now. We're just passing everything into Windows Subsystem for Linux, cross-compiling it, putting it into another special secret, which we can see now, which is UPX, Universal Package, Packager for Executables. Which is, what it does is it zips your executable one time more and put in a safe extractor in. So you get about a ratio, which you can see here, which says Go files are very compressible at around 50%. You can compress the size down. So if you do if we see here, we can see that the compressed binary, which plays audio, for example, for the robot, is now compressed to 3.5 megabyte, which is very important because the robot, of course, doesn't have a big HD drive, which 1 terabyte or so. I think we have about 200 megabytes for user space programs, which isn't very much. And so it's important to get it a little bit down. And to show it, I will run it on this machine. Yeah, the front end is built in Angular, and if you don't put out this line and comment it out, it was always building the complete front end with you. And as we know, node modules are a lot of downloading. So now we have the file for, again, in the form. We got our executable for Windows, which is a lot bigger, because I think the compiled in Windows drivers for audio, but if we execute it now, we can. Please, Windows. Always the same. So I have prepared a little cheat sheet here for me. And if we put some curl commands or voodoo magic, or someone likes to use Postman, for example, which is another cool tool, we should get some audio here, which would be possible to play out. And when we, for example, want to change the volume, we can directly put in a command to do this. The fun part is that our ears are not linear, our ears are logarithmic. That's why we, if you don't scale it to 50%, we doesn't hear anything. So that's the magic for the volume. And if anyone is curious how I did this, if you have Pulse modulated codecs for audio, which is just zeros and one and bit streams, you can directly scale them down, the samples from the WAV file, for example, and scale it down in between the decoder and the player. So after the MP3 decoder, you had to have an PCM file, and then you can decode the individual samples down to your volume. And then we can stop it again. And yeah. The part about playing is exactly what I showed in the slides before. So there's no magic more added. The magic is more for the REST API or something like this, or to bring it over to the robot with packing it with a cross compiler for Go and so on. And if we want to see the UI, I have a little demo for that too. Yeah, I'm awkward at UIs, that's why it's looking this way. And we can do the same from here. Didn't I start it? Demo God's not here. Where's Casey Hightower if you need him? So, okay, it doesn't work with that now. I don't know why. But what we can show in advance is a little video that you trust me, it's really running on my robot and not on my PC. That's why I got, yeah, I thought first of bringing the device with me, but it is very heavy and very annoying. So, yeah, you can see that the UI normally works. And there's a robot who's playing my music. And if you combine it with a little bit of Chrome, you can do it into an alarm clock at 6 o'clock or where you want, and you can change the song via the internet if you put the files on a file server or something like this. Yeah, that's the volume scaling and such things. Yeah. Go back to my slides. So if there are some questions, there are, I think, 2 to 3 minutes to talk a little bit about this or ask me some stuff, what I have to deal with. Yeah, please. Yeah, physically, it's as I said, we have root access. You, if you merge or put on your own software on there, the guys who hacked it had a script which builds your own firmware for the robot. And you put in the firmware, and before you build the firmware, you can put in your SSH key, and then you can SSH into. If I have a SCP command directly in Mage, which copies over, executes, it, and fine. So SSH. Same question here, or? Yeah, of course, that's the next way. And there are possibilities on the robot. It's very very nice. Xiaomi have left nearly everything of their debug tools on this device, so you can directly communicate. There's a debug tool where you feed in audio, for example, if you don't want to use the audio driver, you can directly put it in, and they are streaming it over UART, streaming it to the coprocessor, or if you want to interact with the buttons, you can catch the fire, catch the interrupts and everything. So it's very nice that you can use the debug tools. So if anyone has ideas now in his mind, use this robot. Everything is there. More questions? Please. Yeah, of course. Yeah, the sources are, of course, open source, because why not? The only thing which what I didn't put in is a compiled binary for the robot, for the sound driver, because it's not allowed for me to put it in there. The license is very hard, so that's why you have to compile it by your own. But there are instructions how you can compile it. You can, from the robot, you can directly pull down some files, the root file system, put it together with some Ubuntu magic and cross-compiler, and then you can shroot into the system and build everything on top of it. More questions? Please. Yeah, that's possible, but I noticed if you play music, because the MP3 decoding in raw Go is a little bit overwhelming for the small CPU, you can see that it is his decisions are very slow. So he sees something, and the music is playing, and you can directly see that the program which normally calculates the path doesn't have enough CPU time anymore, and you can see that it is slowly moving and is a little bit like a drunken robot. Yeah. More questions, or are we? Then I'm done for my part. If you have more questions, I'm still around, and you can ask me, or we can talk about it. Yeah. Thanks.